What I want to start off with is just a quick revisit of the diagnostic criteria for mania. And the reason I want to do so is not because I want to go through any detail in the DSM-5 or ICD-11, but just to make a single point. And that is that for the past 30 to 40 years, what was the central and defining feature of mania was the presence of an elated and expansive and or an irritable mood. That was the defining feature. And that defining feature also needed to be accompanied by other features of mania to make the diagnosis of a manic episode. The DSM-5, when it first appeared in 2013, made a change to the diagnostic criteria of mania, which is conceptually and academically interesting, but clinically also important to be aware of. In addition to having an elated, expansive, and or irritable mood, you also needed to have an increase in energy and or increase in activity. In other words, what the authors of DSM-5 did is they narrowed the goalpost a little bit. What they did was, is they said, being moody is not enough. There has to be mood and there has to be an increase in activity and energy along with the other symptoms. Three of the seven items listed in the DSM, or four if your mood is irritable. Now I start off with that because we're gonna be talking about making the diagnosis. Patients come to us typically in a state of depression, and we have the unenviable task of trying to arrive at an accurate diagnosis based on retrospective information or recall, and we're trying to think about, is there anything about the history that I should be especially paying attention to that would increase my level of suspicion? And over the years, we've really emphasized elation. And to this day, I have residents who work with me, and they'll ask patients, have you ever had a time where your mood was very high, you felt very joyful, over excessive, and so on? There's nothing wrong with the question, but the question is very limited with respect to its real world validity. Because the real world presentation of bipolarity doesn't typically manifest that way. The real world presentation of mania or hypomania, rather than being elated, tends to be more irritable, more dysphoric, suffused with excess energy and activity. These folks are often labeled as anxious, as agitated, as having major depressive disorder. I've commented here at NEI over the years my sort of musings on the topic, and I've wondered, quite frankly, where have all the elated patients gone? Don't you ever wonder that? Where are they? And right around the world, we are hearing from colleagues all points of the globe, we're seeing less of the classic euphoria and more of the dysphoria, irritability, that agitation. And that's not just an academic point, because we are missing the diagnosis very frequently in people who are coming to care centers. These are not people who are sitting at home suffering, that's happening as well, but they're coming to the healthcare system and they're being missed. So won't get too caught up in all this diagnostic criteria, but for me, that's something I'm always listening for. We're gonna come back to this increase in activity.